Hey guys, what is up? It is Ruth, another video. Welcome back, people of Earth.
What is up?
I'm actually gonna begin the video by sadly saying that I will not be doing a part three of fall treats. I really wanted to do them, but I decided actually to just wait till next year and focus on, you know, what's the next holiday. Since this is going to be Christmas treats and on, that means
jingle bells, jingle all the way.
That's right, guys. It is now the commence of the ultimate Christmas taste test. Depending if I split it in two videos, I'll be dropping one in early December, and then I'll be dropping one a week before Christmas, so you guys can have time to check it out. If I do post it after Christmas, that's actually a little bit better because some places actually stop selling till January. So I will put all that information down in the description if you're interested. I'm really excited, tis the season. Cannot wait to try these Christmas treats.
Oh yeah.
Good morning, everybody. Why do I have so much energy this early in the morning? It's not even 7 a.m. But I think I know why. Happy day one of Romina's fast food ultimate Christmas taste test. That's right, it is November, so happy November, everybody. It is so funny how I commenced the Halloween taste test with Starbucks, and today we're commencing Christmas with Starbucks as well. No, these aren't the drinks. I can't drink coffee, so we're just gonna do their bakery goodies, which they have four this year, and I'm so excited because I've tried none of them. I have four things in front of me. I have a sugar plum danish, I have a snowman cookie, a cranberry bliss bar, and a reindeer cake pop. So we're actually gonna begin with the reindeer cake pop. Vanilla cake interior with chocolatey icing, finished with a festive red nose and antlers. I'm not a fan of cake pops as much, but this one's actually pretty better than decent. I think I like vanilla cake pops more than chocolate. This is really good. 4 out of 5. Next, we have the snowman cookie. There must be a little magic in this buttery shortbread snowman cookie dressed up in a white chocolate icing. You know what's better than sugar cookies? Buttery cookies. Let's take a bite of his head. Let's behead the snowman. I want to give this a Lady Gaga moment. Something is telling me 4.5. Frick it. This is a 5 out of 5. I would give this again. 5 out of 5. Next is the cranberry bliss bar. I hope this is cream cheese frosting. A blondie cake with dried cranberries, finished with a layer of cream cheese icing, flecked with orange zest, and a sprinkle of dried cranberries, a holiday extravaganza of undeniable yum. We're getting another Cheesecake Factory pumpkin pecan cheesecake moment. The dried cranberries are very sweet and they're very strong. Cream cheese icing is also potent. Not only that, there's cranberries on top and there's cranberries inside. So, I mean, it's not gross. I think I would do with like less cranberries. I think this is actually better than decent. Like, I actually like this. It's just very strong. 3.5 out of 5. Last but not least, we have the sugar plum danish, which I love cheese danishes. Cream cheese filling surrounded by a fluffy danish, topped with spiced sugar plum spread, a dreamy combination of flavors that will inspire visions of this holiday delight long after your last bite. Let's see if it does. That does not have any business being that good. Five out of five. Lady Gaga. I forgot to tell you the time and date. Happy Saturday, November 6th, 6:51 a.m. So this was a good start. It's funny, we always start great when we start with Starbucks. And tonight, I'm going to be trying another holiday treat because let's kill two birds in one stone.
Hi, can I have a McRib meal, medium? And that's it. Thank you so much.
Hello, my friends. I can't fit my turkey hat on the entire the camera, so I had to tilt it a bit. It's later in the day. It's actually, oh my god, it is almost 9 p.m. It's 8:55 and it's dinner time, and it's not just dinner time. It is Mickey time. A fan favorite I never tried is the McRib. It's funny, my dad is a fanatic of the McRib. yet I never bothered to ask for a bite to try it. This is the first year. I don't know how many years the McRib has been on the seasonal Christmas menu at McDonald's, but it's a fan favorite. Dare I say a cult favorite. Seasoned boneless pork dipped in tangy barbecue sauce, topped with silvered onions, crunchy dill pickle chips, and served on a toasted home-style bun. So let's open this baby up. Woo! Messy barbecue sauce, you can already tell. Mmm. Okay, let me take another bite. Okay, the pork is very strong. If you were to take out pickles, onions, and just have the meat in the bun, I wouldn't think it's that delicious. But the pickles complement the sandwich so well. So did the onions, and the barbecue sauce is very good. I love this bread, but to be honest, I'm not wowed. I honestly thought I was gonna bite into it and be like, McRib energy is exploding inside my veins. Like McDonald's Sprite. I actually would not get the McRib again. And I'm currently missing my quarter pounder at the moment. But 3 out of 5. I'm actually pretty disappointed because I had high expectations for the McRib. Hey guys, happy Sunday! Oh, wait, where's my turkey hat? We gotta complete the saga. I've been wearing this turkey hat for the weekend. It is almost 6 o'clock, November 7th, and we have El Pollo Loco. They have new tamale bowls. So they have a couple of holiday favorites, but I'm only trying one, and I have a couple reasons why. I'm not trying their Mexican hot chocolate because I am gonna try that later this week. They have chicken pozole verde, and I absolutely despise pozole. I don't like it. I'm sorry. It's not my forte. I've tried it, and no ma'am. And then they have 3 types of tamale bowls, but they're all kind of the same. They have a tamale and 2-piece chicken bowl, so you can get a leg and a thigh. They have a tamale and a taco bowl, or you can get the double tamale avocado bowl. Then everything is on a bed of rice and beans. So I ordered a leg on the side, so I'm basically trying the tamale 2-piece bowl. I ordered a taco on the side to just try it because I never had it. So I'm basically trying everything in one. So I ordered today the double tamale avocado bowl. Double avocado tamale bowl comes with rice, red chili chicken tamale, queso fresco, avocado, pinto beans, enchilada sauce, and cilantro. I'm not a fan of beans in general, so I got mine without beans. It smells so good. I love the rice. I'm obsessed. Besides the mac and cheese, freaking love the rice. We're gonna try to get everything in one. Boy! Mm-hmm. This is so good. The tamale is not dry. It is juicy with a good portion of chicken. And everything complements each other really well. Avocado for freshness. Because usually if you have, like, let's say rice, beans, tortilla in one, very dry. Enchilada sauce adds this, like, tanginess to the tamale. And then the melted queso fresco is so good. I thought it was going to be, like, feta cheese texture because that's kind of how queso fresco tastes. But because everything is steaming hot and melts the cheese, this is so delicious. No freaking way. This is Lady Gaga. 5 out of freaking 5. Hello.
Hi,
good evening. Can I just please have 2 Mexican hot chocolates?
2 hot chocolates, okay.
And that will be all. Thank you so much. Hey guys, happy Wednesday, November 10th. It is almost 6:30. I just came back from seeing Clifford. No joke. I came back from seeing Clifford. You bet a letterbox review is coming. At my AMC, there's a Pollo Loco with a drive-thru. So I was like, oh, let's stop by and get another holiday item I didn't get this past Sunday. And that is the Mexican hot chocolate. I love hot chocolate. I'm obsessed with hot chocolate. This is going to complete the holiday favorites of Pollo Loco that they bring back. Abuelita hot cocoa, cinnamon sugar, and real whipped cream topping. Pretty decent size. I think this is good, though I always get my hot chocolate large, but let's open it up and see how it looks inside. Okay, so that's a little disappointing. I think they didn't have any whipped cream, or maybe the whipped cream melted, because I saw a red whipped can there, so maybe they forgot, maybe it melted, whatever. It's okay. Let's try it. This slaps so hard. Oh my god. This is so comforting. I will say, as a sugar demon, I would want it to be just a little sweeter, but this is delicious. I actually love the cinnamon sugar in there, and it's not overpowering at all. Pollo Loco, freaking 5 out of 5. the red hot flush, probably sweaty through the camera face. I just got off work, and the only time I could pick up these drinks I'm about to show you was after work. Happy Thursday, November 11th. It is 3:05 p.m., and today's crazy. Everywhere is packed. At work, it was freaking crazy. But anyway, it's also very hot, so I decided to try Shake Shack's holiday drinks, and I'm talking every single holiday drink they have. They have six in total. I have three milkshakes and three cider-aids, is what they call them. This is only four though. I have two more back there. So for their milkshakes, I am first going to try their chocolate milk and cookies. Chocolate cookies hand spun with malted chocolate frozen custard topped with whipped cream and chocolate cookie crumbles. Wow. Okay. I'm a milkshake person, but when it comes to milkshakes, I'm a cookies and cream person literally everywhere. I never get chocolate. This is very good, but it's very chocolatey. I love the crunch of the cookies. I wish there was more whipped cream, but as flavor, this is very good. If you have a hella sweet tooth like me, I love sweets. This is actually very good. Oh my gosh, 5 out of 5. Next up, we have the Sugar Plum Fairy Raspberry Jam Linzer Cookies, hand spun with vanilla frozen custard, topped with whipped cream, sprinkled with white chocolate fairy bark. Wow. Just like the chocolate, raspberry is definitely there. I actually feel that I'm eating a sugar plum fairy.
I think what I love about Shake Shack's Christmas drink so far, and I still have one more milkshake, is that this is like flavor in your mouth. This is a party in my taste buds.
This is so impressive. But I will say, this isn't a perfect 5 out of 5, 4.5 out of 5. I'm not sure if I would get this again. I already have my preferences for milkshakes, and I don't think this is as superb to get me to order it again. Last on the shakes is Christmas cookies, which this is the one I was so excited for because I love vanilla and I love cookies. Sugar cookie frozen custard topped with whipped cream and holiday sprinkles. Nice, sweet, and simple,
and I'm excited.
Okay, very sweet. I love the taste, but I wish there was more sugar cookie blended in this drink, just like I tried in the chocolate one and the sugar plum one, because it honestly would bump it up a higher score if it had more crunchiness in this milkshake. I'm just getting a lot of liquid because of that, and the flavor not being enough to be that superb. This is a 4 out of 5. It is so funny how the one that I was nervous to try because it's chocolate and cookies and it can be overload is my favorite one. I love this one. Double fisting. Mix them together. Should we try three at a time? If I were to give a cumulative score to these milkshakes, Shake Shack's holiday shake so far reigns supreme, and it's a 4.5 out of 5. Now let's move on to the cider-aids. They didn't distinguish which one's which, so we're just gonna play around. So let's begin with the apple cider-aid, and then we will distinguish which one's the cran citrus and which one's the pomegranate lemonade. So many drinks. So Shake Shack is not only taking out Christmas milkshakes, they're also taking out winterades. So this is the apple cider-aide. Real apple cider mixed with vanilla and Shack-made lemonade. I never tried Shake Shack's lemonade, so we're going to see. Not only that, but there's vanilla in this, so let's try it.
Okay,
I'm not a fan of this. I think this is a very good drink if you're looking to cut so much sweet during the day. It grows on you, but it's not the best flavor. Not impressed, and I would not order it again. So this gets 3 out of 5. I feel like I'm being kind of nice because I was about to say 2 out of 5, but 2 sips is not enough because I do think this could fit a certain occasion. So I think it's just decent. Next one we have, I think this is the cran citrus punch. Real cranberry and white grape juices mixed with real orange and lemonade. Listen, I've been on a lemonade obsession. I've always loved lemonade, but I've just been recently been very obsessed with it. I've never tried Shake Shack lemonade, so maybe I'd have to go back and try it. I really don't know which one I'm drinking. Let me try the other one because they look like the same color, but this one looks lighter. So I think this is the pomegranate lemonade. This is the cran citrus. This is good. I would actually get this over regular lemonade. Let me try the other one and just see. This should be the pomegranate yuzu lemonade. Real yuzu, which I don't know what that is, and pomegranate juices mixed with Shake Shack made lemonade. This is the yuzu.
I don't like this one. I like this one. This is the cran citrus one. It's refreshing, probably because orange is so good. This easily gets a 5 out of 5. Kind of want to give it a 1, kind of want to give it a 2. 2 out of 5. Because I took a couple sips and it's nothing like, ugh, but I wouldn't finish this all. And unfortunately, Shake Shack's winterades aren't my faves. I only liked 1 out of these 3, but that's okay. They did so freaking well on milkshakes and I'm so excited to chug down 3 milkshakes.
Good morning, guys. Welcome back to my kitchen. It is 5:45 a.m. right now, Saturday, November 20th. And if you hear noises in the background, it's because breakfast is cooking. I'm cooking some bacon and eggs to go along with a new holiday treat I'm trying this morning for breakfast. We are having Dunkin' today. Again, no drinks, but Dunkin' did take out one treat that is holiday, and then they're gonna bring out more in December. They have a cranberry orange muffin, and that's what we're going to try today. Orange flavored muffin topped with sugar and made with cranberries. If there's something else that screams Christmas holiday than peppermint, it's cranberry. The pumpkin muffin let me down this year back in October, so we're gonna see what the cranberry does, but it smells really good. Oh my God, This reminds me a lot of a cake I used to eat as a kid. Perfect ratio of cranberries. You can see a lot are inside. But what is the game changer? It's 2 things. Okay, 3 things. The taste of the muffin, because all the flavors blend in together. The texture of the muffin, very soft, but the glazed sugar on top adds this perfect crunch that sprinkles technically do. No, I love this a lot. And it tastes like Christmas. 5 out of 5. Good job, Dunkin'. Mornings run on Dunkin'. Hey guys, happy Friday, the day after Thanksgiving. I hope you guys had an amazing Thanksgiving. And for those who don't celebrate, I hope you had an amazing Thursday. Happy Friday, like I said. I have another fall treat. We have McDonald's today. I have to go to work in like less than an hour. And I was just scrolling through Postmates because I was just starting to plan my days to try more treats. And I saw on McDonald's that they finally had the holiday pie. The holiday pie came back a couple days ago, but my local McDonald's didn't have it on the menu. And here it is. Creamy smooth vanilla custard nestled in a flaky buttery crust, glazed with sugar and topped with rainbow sprinkles. That was weird. As you can see, my reaction just did a full 360. When you bite into it, vanilla custard is delicious. It actually feels like Christmas explodes in my mouth. And then I keep chewing it, and this aftertaste, it tastes like cardboard. I want to dislike it, yet I want to like it, but I want to dislike it again. Also, my pie crust feels like it wasn't cooked enough. I want to leave this undecided, but TBH, 3 out of 5. I'm a little disappointed because the pumpkin cream pie was the best thing I've ever tasted, better than the McDonald's apple pie. Dang, McDonald's. Good morning, people of Earth. Happy Saturday, November 27th, 6:12 a.m. in the morning. I think Krispy Kreme's was like, okay, Thanksgiving's over. It is December time. Because yesterday, the 26th, they released their Christmas donuts. They usually release it sometime in December, but they decided to drop it early this year, and I scored them. I got one of each, and there's, let's see, 5 new donuts. The first one is actually a returning fan favorite, which is the Santa Belly Donut. A fan favorite filled with chocolate cream dipped in red icing and decorated like the big guy with icing and a bell fondant piece. I would actually get this again. 5 out of 5. I'm not a Krispy Kreme girl, but this is very good. The chocolate cream complements the donut so freaking well. It's a cute design. It's Santa. It screams Christmas. Let's continue with filled donuts because the next one is Patty Penguin Donut. A donut filled with original cream dipped in icing and decorated with cream and a cute penguin fondant piece. We're gonna eat Patty the Penguin. I can't believe simpler Christmas donuts are hitting it out of the park more than the Halloween ones I tried. I think what bumps this up so high is the freaking sugar crystals up here. 5 out of 5. Third one is snowman smile donut, which I'm a sucker for snowmen during the holidays, just like I'm a sucker for jack-o'-lanterns and skeletons in Halloween. This is cute. An original glazed donut dipped in white icing and decorated like a smiling snowman with a fondant piece. Unfortunately, this is style over substance. The icing doesn't change any flavor, and it really doesn't add anything. It's not exploding with flavor or any kind of pizzazz or originality, besides just being a snowman. So, 3 out of 5. It's cute though. Second to last is a snowy sprinkle, an original glazed donut dipped in blue icing and topped with a snowflake sprinkle blend. So just like witches, I think they're going with a very bright yellow winter wonderland kind of color palette. You'd think that this would be exactly like the snowman smile, because technically it is, but like I said, a little snowflake sprinkle blend adds this beautiful crunch. It just complements the donut more. It's not just a basic donut covered in Christmas, which that's basically what Christmas donuts are, but some of them offer something new. So I actually love this one. It tastes just a hint little different. Dare I say, because I will, 4 out of 5. Last one is a basic one, but we gotta get Everstone Christmas donuts for this to be an ultimate taste test. An original glazed donut dipped in chocolate icing and topped with a holiday sprinkle blend. These slap hard though. I love chocolate icing on glazed donuts at Krispy Kreme. It tastes like hot cocoa. This easily gets a 3.5 out of 5. Listen, I am a Halloween person, number one for life, but Krispy Kreme's Christmas donuts beat the Halloween donuts I tried 2 months ago. Merry Christmas. Good morning, everybody. Okay, so yesterday, Sunday, November 27th, I was going to try a Christmas treat, but honestly, I was so full that if I bit into a piece of food, I'd probably explode. So this is now the end of part one. Stay tuned for part two. December's this week, so I have something planned for the 1st of December and other days to come. That is all for today's video. If you love to give it a thumbs up, if you hate to give it a thumbs down, if you like to more thumbs up, press the subscribe button, subscribe to my YouTube channel, and I will see you all in part two.